Alert. ICE agent commits suicide in NYC, leaves note revealing government plans to round up and disarm Americans during economic and bank collapse and left a very strange suicide note. Paranoid friends, this is a repost from a number of news sources. I will try to provide what I have gathered and why a U.S. customs agent would say and do this. From the newsroom at www.superstation95.com. After writing a lengthy suicide note exposing terrifying plans the government has for American citizens, a U.S. customs agent walked onto a pier in NYC and blew his brains out. Sources inside the New York City Police Department have revealed to Superstation 95 the contents of a suicide note found on the body, and they are utterly frightening. The note, which says it was written over the course of a full week in advance, outlines why the officer chose to shoot himself. The America I grew up in and cherished has been murdered by its own federal government. Our Constitution has become meaningless and our laws politicized so badly, they are no longer enforced except for political purposes, the note said. Our elected officials are, to a person, utterly corrupt and completely devoid of any love or respect for the country which pays them. To them, everything is about getting and keeping power, and making illicit money from backroom deals. The 42-year-old U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement deportation officer shot himself with a .40-caliber service pistol inside Pier 40 in Hudson River Park at around 11 a.m. 1. A source at the scene described how the officer calmly walked into the park, took out his pistol and shot himself in the head. The 42-year-old worked as U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement deportation officer, and his offices were nearby to the scene of the shooting. He was rushed to Lenox Hill Hospital, but doctors were unable to save him. 2. ICE released a statement Friday afternoon. Tragically, a U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement, ICE, deportation officer from the New York field office suffered a self-inflicted gunshot wound and has passed away. It added, the agency is not releasing further details pending notification of the officer's next of kin. According to the suicide note, the officer said, I was hired to enforce the law, to capture and deport people who come to this country against our laws. But now, if I dare to do that, I face being suspended or fired because our president refuses to faithfully execute the duties of his office. Instead, I come to work each day, and collect a paycheck twice a month, for intentionally doing little to nothing. I cannot and will not be party to this fraud, to this usurpation of the law, or to the despicable politicians betraying our nation, the note continued. ICE's Office of Professional Responsibility is reviewing the matter and coordinating with the New York Police Department on the investigation. The agent worked at a field office in Lower Manhattan, just blocks away from the scene of the shooting. Mentions FEMA camps for Americans, 3. In the suicide note, the officer revealed what he claimed are terrifying plans the feds have been finalizing. If the American people knew what this government is planning, they would rise up and overthrow it. If I or anyone else in the federal government revealed what is coming, we would be killed anyway, so now I will reveal what I know. We in federal law enforcement have been drilling for several years to control riots and uprisings from a coming financial collapse and widespread bank failures. The drills involve life-sized images of American men, even women, and children, whom we are told to shoot for practice and to get used to it. We have been told that the economy is terminally ill and will fail in 2016. We are also told the banks are all insolvent and the FDIC doesn't have nearly enough funds to bail out depositors. We are told these events are unavoidable and it is imperative that the government survive when people rise up over this. When the collapse takes place, detention camps created under the FEMA Rex 84 program in the 1980s to house illegal aliens whom we were going to deport, will instead be used to imprison American citizens whom the government feels constitute a threat. American citizens will be rounded up without warrants and imprisoned without trial for God knows how long. These camps have been equipped to carry out Hitler-scale killings. An actual purge of American citizens by the very government which they, themselves, created and pay for. I cannot be party to this. The note goes on to say talk about state-level National Guard being disarmed by the feds, 4, and over 1 billion rounds of ammunition purchased by the feds, 5, and the military overdeployed and being shrunk, 6. The government knows the military will rise up to stop this, so our military is being deployed overseas, intentionally involved in foreign fights, and deliberately shrunk in size so they cannot be here or help Americans. This is why certain ammunition and weaponry has been removed from state-level National Guard armories and over a billion rounds of hollow-point ammunition has been bought by the federal government. The states themselves have been disarmed of military-grade firepower so they cannot defend themselves from the federal activities. This is also why local police departments have been militarized and provided with armored vehicles and weapons of war, the note says. When the inevitable collapse begins to take place, electric power to the entire country will be shut off, as will all forms of communication. All banks will be immediately closed, no one will be able to get any money because all ATMs will be offline. Credit, debit, and EBT cards will not function. Anyone without cash will have no way to get any. The emergency alert system will be used to take over all broadcast stations and tell the public this is a result of a cyber attack. But while the American people patiently await things to get back to normal, the government will unleash round UPS of citizens they deem militants or dangerous. With all civilian communications out, and all TV and radio stations taken over by the emergency alert system, by the time word spreads of what is taking place, the government will already have the upper hand. Federal prisoners to be gassed to death. The note goes into a wide array of very specific plans and does so in extremely specific detail about what the feds are allegedly planning. For instance, it talks about federal prisons. Every federal prison has been outfitted with lethal gas systems. When things go bad, all prisoners in all prisons will be placed in their cells on lockdown. Prison staff will depart the facility, and a certain designated person will trigger a lethal gas system. All federal prisoners, regardless of their crime or their sentence, will be gassed to death in their cells. Once the gas clears, the dead will be removed and the prisons will then be used to house citizens who fight against the federal onslaught. Priests recruited to quell opposition, 7. The note makes mention about priests, rabbis, and clerics from various religious denominations having been recruited and trained to quell resistance. So intent is the government to succeed they have recruited priests, rabbis, and clerics from various religions to quote appropriate scriptures about obeying government. They are being trained to tell people not to fight back and that their best hope is to pray. Executive Order 136038. The suicide note goes to great lengths about Executive Order No. 13603 signed by President Obama on March 16, 2012. The note details. Executive Order 13603 about National Defense Resources Preparedness. This 10-page document is a blueprint for a federal takeover of the economy. Specifically, Obama's plan involves seizing control of asterisk all commodities and products that are capable of being ingested by either human beings or animals. Asterisk all forms of energy. Asterisk all forms of civil transportation. Asterisk all usable water from all sources. Asterisk health resources, drugs, biological products, medical devices, materials, facilities, health supplies, services, and equipment. Asterisk forced labor, or induction as the executive order delicately refers to military conscription. Moreover, federal officials would issue regulations to prioritize and allocate resources. Superstation 95 took a look at this executive order from the Government Printing Office, GPO. And, sure enough, everything contained in the officer's suicide note about this executive order is true. To be sure, much of this language has appeared in national security executive orders that previous presidents have issued periodically since the beginning of the Cold War. But more than previous national security executive orders, Obama's 13603 seems to describe a potentially totalitarian regime obsessed with control over everything. Obama's executive order makes no effort to justify the destruction of liberty, no effort to explain how amassing totalitarian control would enable government to deal effectively with cyber sabotage, suicide bombings, chemical warfare, nuclear missiles, or other possible threats. There's nothing in Executive Order 13603 about upholding the Constitution or protecting civil liberties. In what circumstances, one might ask, would a president try to carry out this audacious plan? Executive Order 13603 says with ominous ambiguity, during the full spectrum of emergencies. Database of Preppers. The suicide note touches on the subject of preppers. We in federal law enforcement have also been told that the government has a full database of all so-called preppers. Those people will be dealt with first by armed federal agents coming to take their guns, then their food stocks, so food can be redistributed as the government sees fit. If the dead officer's claims about an unavoidable economic and banking collapse are true, would it then follow that the executive order put in place by Obama might be activated? Would all of us find ourselves in forced labor, while the government takes our food and redistributes it under the executive order's paragraph about allocating resources? This is terrifying stuff. There is much more to the suicide note, and Superstation 95 is considering how much more to publish. As such, this is a developing story and readers should check back for further updates. These could simply be insane ramblings. It is not our intent to cause panic or alarm, and while we expect readers to be intelligent enough to discern this on their own, we feel compelled to point out that these could simply be paranoid ramblings of an insane person who killed himself. On the other hand, these could also be revelations by a person who was so distraught over the ugly truth that he killed himself. We at Superstation 95 just don't know. We urge everyone to stay calm, think rationally, and decide whether or not to take any action to prepare, in case this person's suicide note is telling the truth. Stay paranoid, my friends. Sourcing/corroboration. 1. ICE agent suicide in NYC, New York Daily News. 2. Taken to Lenox Hill Hospital, New York Post. 3. Rex 84 FEMA camps Wikipedia. 4. National Guard being stripped of crew serviceable weapons and communications gear, Republic Broadcasting, John Stad Miller. 5. Department of Homeland Security orders 1.6 billion rounds of ammunition, Forbes magazine. 6. U.S. Army overdeployed and intentionally shrunk Army times. 7. Clergy recruited by government to quell opposition, KSLA TV Channel 12. 8. Executive Order 13603, White House U.S. Government Printing Office. Very strange suicide note. Paranoid friends, this is a repost from a number of news sources. I will try to provide what I have gathered and why a U.S. customs agent would say and do this. From the newsroom at www.superstation95.com. After writing a lengthy suicide note exposing terrifying plans the government has for American citizens, a U.S. customs agent walked onto a pier in NYC and blew his brains out. Sources inside the New York City Police Department. Alert! ICE agent commits suicide in NYC. Leaves note revealing government plans to round up and disarm Americans during economic and bank collapse, and left abrupt and completely devoid of any love or respect for the country which pays them. To them, everything is about getting and keeping power, and making illicit money from backroom deals. The 42-year-old U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement deportation officer shot himself with a .40-caliber service pistol inside Pier 40 in Hudson River Park at around 11 a.m. 1. A source at the scene described how the officer calmly walked into the park, took out his pistol and shot himself in the head. The 42-year-old worked as U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement deportation officer, and his offices were nearby to the scene of the shooting. He was rushed to Lenox Hill Hospital, but doctors were unable to save him. 2. ICE released a statement Friday afternoon. Tragically, a U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement, ICE, deportation officer from the New York field office suffered a self-inflicted gunshot wound and has passed away. It added, the agency is not releasing further details PENT have revealed to Superstation 95, the contents of a suicide note found on the body and they are utterly frightening. The note, which says it was written over the course of a full week in advance, outlines why the officer chose to shoot himself. The America I grew up in, and cherished, has been murdered by its own federal government. Our Constitution has become meaningless and our laws politicized so badly, they are no longer enforced except for political purposes, the note said. Our elected officials are, to a person, utterly corrupt.